It is also true that the emerging conditions are hurting Kenyans at the individual domestic front, as I said last week. Some degree of traveling remains inevitable, regardless that the country is shutting down, or that it will be shut down. People must still travel to find food. They need to find health care and to find other essentials. The necessary measures that have been introduced to minimize the chances of spreading the virus through public transport come with challenges. One of these is cost, both for the commuter and the owner of the transport. There is need to look at taxation on petroleum products afresh in order to give Kenyans some level of relief. Citizens also need support in access to water, both for health purposes and as an essential nutritional need. In the same docket are steady supplies of electricity and paraffin for cooking purposes. I have previously addressed the need for cushioning both house renters and landlords. A crisis or even a shutdown law may need to be urgently enacted. You cannot fight a virus if you are malnourished and your immunity system is compromised.